All right, I'm here with ChannelFireball.com's newest writer, Tomoharu Saito. Thank you for joining us, Saito-san.
Thank you.
And we're here looking at your deck. You chose Hypergenesis for this tournament. Why did you choose Hypergenesis?
今日のトーナメント、なぜハイパージェネシスをデックとして選んだんですか？
まずワールドウェイクのカードを並べて最初に見てるときに、うちに来た友達がハイパージェネシスにこのテラストドン入れたらすごいんじゃないっていう。
So he says when World Wake came out, his friend came over and they were playing and they said, well, this Terastodon card seems like it would be pretty good in Hypergenesis.
言っていて、僕もあ、それはすごいことになるなっていう感じで、でそこからなんかいつものズーかハイパージェネシスかみたいなので一回考え置いておいて、結局サンディエゴの練習にプロツアーの練習に時間を使って、でまああまりこのデッキいなそうだしメタられてなさそうだし一番多そうなズーに強そうだということでこれを選びました。
So he thought the Terastodon thing was a great idea and they were testing it out. Mm-hmm. It was either going to be Hypergenesis or Zoo. And when they actually tested that specific matchup, he said it was really, really good against Zoo. And that's when he decided to play this.
So did the Terastodon end up being an all-star during this tournament?
じゃあこのトーナメント GP オークランドでテラストドンはどうでしたか？
めちゃくちゃ強かった。
He says it was super, super good.
Yeah, I mean...And we were talking about it earlier. There's also this great interaction between Terastodon and Oblivion Ring. Were you able to abuse that the whole weekend?
さっき話してたテラスタドンとオブリビオンリング使いましたか？トーナメントで。
はい。
さっき話してたこと。
使いました。2種類のコンボを。
So yeah, he said he used two different types of combos.
じゃあちょっと説明をもう一回。
はい。
So when Hypergenesis resolves,
解決した後に、この2枚を出した
。You put these two cards into play together, possibly with other things, but we'll just talk about these two.
で、一つ目は対戦相手のクリーチャーを先にこれで消しますって言って。
First combo is you have opponent has a permanent, you target it with Oblivion Ring.
からこれで割ると
And then you put the Terastodon ability on the stack to remove it. So it's kind of the old Oblivion Ring combo of removing it in response.
So the creature never comes back because of the way it's stacked, it comes back before it's ever removed.
Right, exactly.
で、2つ目が
So the other one is a little different.
テラストドンで先に、例えば土地。
So if you have some lands,
これ対戦相手の土地だとして、テラストドンで先に、対戦相手の土地2枚と
So you target two of your opponent's lands and the Oblivion Ring with the Terastodon.
取った後にこれの対象をこれ選ぶと
And then you target the Terastodon itself with the Oblivion Ring.
で、テラストドンの効果でこれが破壊されてトークンが3つ
So the Oblivion Ring removes the Terastodon and then you resolve the Terastodon ability destroying two lands.And the Oblivion Ring. So once the Oblivion Ring is destroyed, Terastodon comes back.
So you...
And then you can target three more non-creature permanents.
You basically get two bites of the apple with the Terastodon.
Yeah. 2回 Terastodon を使えるということですね、それは。Yeah.
So looking back on it, of course, you made top eight, which is, always one of the goals of a tournament, winning being, of course, the top goal. It's hard to say that the deck didn't perform the way you wanted it to, but are there any changes you would make looking back on the weekend?
Top 8入ったのは嬉しいけど、勝てなかったので、なんかデッキをこれから使うとしたら変えることはありますか？
ですね。メインデッキはかなり良かったです。
says the main deck is fine. Wants to talk about the sideboard.
これはまあ、いいとして。
So the ley lines are fine. 何に使いますか？
発掘デッキドレッジと。
Against dredge.
ドレッジ、リビングエンド。
The living end deck, which is a similar deck, the cascade.
Dark depths.
Depths.
No, you keep it out.
あと、iron works.
Oh, combo.
Yeah, versus the Thopter combo to stop the Sword or Meek from coming back. So fire spots against Zoo and other random creature decks.
Meddling Mage とか。
Keep meddling mage from naming your combo. Ingot Shore is against Chalice on zero. So these five he thinks maybe he would change. The Sakashimas are good for the Hypergenesis Mirror.
でこれは苦手なティーチングコントロールとかペアリーとかに使う。
He says the ricochet traps are against fairies and mystical teachings control decks.
受けが狭いので。
But those two decks are not a big part of the field.
So any ideas what you'd put in these slots if you had to do it over?
これ何と交換しますか？
今回ダークデプスが多かったので。
So there's a lot of dark depths.So he says Ghost Quarter against Dark Depths. Malfagor. So he says Sakashima is better against the mirror than Malfagor.
Mm-hmm.
Malfagor could be used in the mirror, but Malfagor also has applications against Dark Depths.
Oh, so
getting rid of the mirror.
It's less good in the mirror, but it's able to switch hit better.
Yes,
so.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
あとは一回ミラーマッチをしたんですけど、その対戦相手がコリエーションレリック、クリエーションレリック、スリーマナ。
Correlation Relic. Sure. Yeah, three mana. Yeah. The charge.
Yeah. 普通にこういうのがプレイしやすいようになってたので、それもまた面白いかなっていう。
So he says he played a mirror match where his opponent had the Coalition Relic, the artifact, to make it easier to hard cast some of these cards in case the combo didn't go off.
Aren't you, I mean, playing the deck, aren't you in a little bit of trouble if you're trying to build a strategy where you're thinking, okay, just in case I have to hard cast these guys, I gotta have an out?
そのレリックを使うときはもうなんか負けてるという感じじゃないですかって、こういう8とか9のプレイするとき。
これもそうなんですけど、もともと邪魔されて、これじゃなくても勝てるゲームがあるように、こういうのが入ってて、実際それは結構起こることなんですね。
So he says the charged lands are in there for the same reason, that there are definitely some games where you have to go to a backup plan, and it's important to take that into consideration.
Well, fair enough, and you can still get yourself out of those situations. It seems like Hypergenesis definitely is not designed to play the long game.
Right.
So I mean, how many long games did he have?
今週マッチで何回？
Yeah.
何回ぐらい全部で？
10回ぐらいあって。
マッ
チゲームで10回ぐらいあって。
Ten games, he says, that went fairly long past the combo point.
3回か4回ぐらいは普通にこれなしで勝ててます。
Oh, wow. And three or four of those he actually won without Hypergenesis at all.
Well,
あとこれを例えば思考囲いでソートシーズで落とさなきゃいけなかったりとか、チャリスが来るまでマリガンとかそういうのでこのデッキにキープできるハンドとできないハンドがあるんで相手がいっぱいマリガンしてぐたぐたになってこれからこれとかで普通に勝つっていうのが実際起こりやすい。
So he says opponents will often mulligan into hate cards like Chalice of the Void and Thoughtseize. And so it's important when they do that you have a way to get past the hate.
Some more resiliency. Yeah. That makes sense.
Because once they know what he's playing, they definitely have cards for him.
Yeah, game two and three. It's, I mean, it's almost like Dredge in type one or something.
Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you for taking time out to talk about the deck. I mean, hypergenesis is something I think, you know, ever since Cascade was introduced as a mechanic, people were talking about playing hypergenesis. It hasn't had the success, I think, in the long run that everyone thought it was going to from the beginning. But here we are in Oakland, and here you are in the top eight. Congratulations.
Hypergenesis は Cascade が出た時みんな話してましたけど、あんまり今までは成功がなかったので、今日は本当におめでとうございます。
ありがとうございます。Thank you.
Thank you.